evening and welcome to the Whiskey Lover Society with me Gert Retief, and today we are looking at a good old favorite of most people and something that everybody can get anywhere in the world, and that is the Chivas Regal 12-year-old blended Scotch whiskey bottled at 40% ABV, cost around 30 to 35 euros here in Europe, and of course it's available in anywhere in the world. Distilled by the Chivas brothers. Have a quick look at the color, of course, probably colored, chill filtered, all those nasty little things to the blended. So when you look at their website, the first thing that they talk about all over the website is cocktails. Now, where I come from in South Africa, this was, when I grew up, it was a classic whiskey. A whiskey that was actually too expensive for most people in where I grew up in. And it was a sipper. That never would have imagined people wanting to use this in a cocktail. But things have changed, and I've seen now that a lot of the 10, 12-year-old whiskies are now being advertised as cocktail type of whiskies. So this one also, on their website, they have quite a number of different cocktails up to using their 18-year-old blended Scotch for a cocktail. But anyway, so let's have a look at the nose, the taste, and we will give it a score. It is kind of nice on the nose. The sweetness is there. Loads and loads of vanilla notes. Brown sugar. Caramel. The toffee notes definitely present in the nose. A little bit of a custard note, the vanilla custard note, quite pleasant. A little bit of a banana note, raisins. Overall, quite sweet. So let's go on and give it a good taste. The sweetness is there. A little bit of a oakiness to it, not overpowering, but it is a little bit of a mid-range on in the oak. And the caramel, the caramel toffee type of note is there, but it is it's not a sweet caramel or a sweet toffee. It's with the bitterness in it, it tends to be making it move away from the sweetness and more into the bitter notes, like your dark chocolates, burnt caramel type of notes. Not unpleasant, but it's also not fantastic. A little bit of a banana note is still there, but it's really faint in the background. And a little bit of orange peel. Maybe going into a little bit of a marmalade and a little bit of a hint of the bitterness that is there. And that's it. Nothing else, nothing special to it. When you take a sip, you get a sweetness, you get the little bit of a coffee notes, the bitter notes. And then it finishes off and it just gives you a little bit of a bitter note in the end. It is a blended Scotch. I didn't expect to find much in it. But I think it is also, like they suggest, maybe it will be better in a cocktail. So the idea is to take these scotches that I have, the Chivas Regal, and my previous videos I was talking also a lot of about cocktails, and of course the King. I'll leave a link in the description for the Monkey Shoulder. For me, that was up to now is still the king of the cocktails. And I've also think it is a good idea to throw in the Johnnie Walker Black Label 12-year-old blended scotch to see what we can do with regards to making a cocktail. So for the next video, I am going to make a free cocktails, or my son is going to make me free cocktails. And the cocktail we decided to make is going to be the old fashioned. So he's going to create three old fashions with the three whiskies in a blind tasting. And I will then do a quick review on the three cocktails and pick my winner. And let's see who's going to be the king of the three cocktail whiskies. So with that, this whiskey, it is, if I compare it to the blended scotches that I've had before, if I look at the Monkey Shoulder, which is a non-age statement one, it's much better than the Chivas Regal. Sorry for the Chivas fans, but yeah, that is very flat and not really much happening in the nose, and also not much happening in the taste. The score-wise, I think I will give it a maximum score of 80 out of 100, and I think I'm being quite generous with that 80 out of 100. So with that, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and keep an eye out for the next video that I'm going to make with regards to the cocktails. And I think it's going to be an interesting one, a little bit of a blind tasting, my first, and I'm looking forward to discussing my findings with regards to cocktails and whiskey.